the development of this megaloblast, we have to understand the concept of nuclear cytoplasmic asynchrony. So that is a very important concept to realize, and I will explain you here. Now, okay, so I will explain you through this diagram. Now look at the left part of this diagram. So here, what I have drawn here, so these are the nucleated RBC or RBC precursors, and then it is becoming a matured RBC. Okay, and then, so look at my pointer. So this one, this is the earliest precursor RBC, and it has a big nucleus here, and then it is becoming it is maturing slowly, and is becoming a matured RBC. Now while it is maturing, what all difference can you see here? First look at the nucleus. Can you see any difference in the nucleus? So definitely it is becoming smaller and smaller. So as it matures through the development, so the nucleus becoming smaller and smaller, and eventually this nucleus disappears and it becomes a mature RBC, which comes out in the peripheral sphere, peripheral blood. So the smaller nucleus is a sign of maturation. But there is another change also you can see. What is the other change? Now look at the cytoplasm. Can you see any color change here? Look at the middle one, the cytoplasm become red. The previous one, cytoplasm is blue. So why it has happened? Because of hemoglobinization. So as it matures, it acquires more and more hemoglobin inside its cytoplasm, so it becomes more reddish. So these are the two changes we find in the development of erythropoiesis. Right, that is the normal development of red blood cell. Now look at the right side of the diagram. What has happened here? Now here, if you see the middle one, now it has, its cytoplasm is red. What does it mean? The cytoplasm has acquired hemoglobinization. So cytoplasm has matured, it has become red in color, so it has normal development. But look at the nucleus. What has happened to the nucleus? It has not become smaller. It was supposed to be small, right? But it has not become smaller. It has retained its normal big size. So nucleus has not matured. So cytoplasm has matured. It has become reddish and hemoglobinized. But nucleus has retained its big size. It has not become smaller. It has not matured. So this one is called as nucleocytoplasmic asynchrony, because nucleus is maturing, but the cytoplasm is maturing, but nucleus is not maturing. So there is an asynchrony. So that's why it is called nucleocytoplasmic asynchrony. And that is the most characteristic finding in the pathogenesis of megaloblastic anemia, B12 deficiency. Now this abnormal nucleated erythroblast, which is showing the nucleocytoplasmic asynchrony, that is called as megaloblast. So what is megaloblast? It is an abnormal erythroblast which is showing nucleocytoplasmic asynchrony. That means here the cytoplasm has matured, but nucleus didn't mature. So that is called megaloblast. So megaloblast is always an abnormal cell. It is an abnormal erythroblast. Okay, so megaloblast is the hallmark for this B12 deficiency anemia. So if you have to confirm the diagnosis of B12 deficiency or folic acid deficiency, you definitely have to find out megaloblast. Without finding the megaloblast, you can't make a diagnosis of B12 deficiency. That's why the name of the anemia is megaloblastic anemia. So this is a very important concept to understand. Okay. Then we'll go to the next slide. Okay. So this is the picture of this megaloblast. How does it look like under microscope? So now here, look at the left one. Now in the left one, it is a normal erythroblast. Here you can see the cytoplasm is bluish, okay, and the nucleus is big, so it is a precursor immature erythroblast. Okay, now look at the left. Look at the right one. Here the cytoplasm has matured because it is not that much blue. It has acquired hemoglobinization. But the nucleus here, although it is little smaller, but it was supposed to be much smaller, much condensed. And one more thing I want to tell you. Now I'll go back to the previous slide. Now look at the configuration of these two nucleus here, in the left side. Follow my pointer. Look at the texture of the nucleus in these two nucleus. Is there any difference in the texture? If you look carefully, you will find that this nucleus in the premature precursor RBC, here you can see very, very small holes, fine holes inside. That is because of its chromatin orientation, chromatin arrangement. So we can find this small kind of holes, and that is called as sieve like appearance or checkerboard appearance. If you find the small fine holes like a sieve, to filter say any liquid, we use the sieve like thing, or a checkerboard appearance. That's how it is described, sieve like chromatin or checkerboard chromatin. Now, when it becomes mature in normal erythropoiesis, so see that checkerboard or sieve-like appearance disappears. It becomes more condensed and dark blue. Look here. So you'll definitely agree with me. But look at this megaloblast in this abnormal erythropoiesis. Now here, this nucleus, it has retained this sieve-like appearance. It has not become smaller. It has almost like same size, like the previous one, and also it has retained that chromatin arrangement, a checkerboard arrangement, a sieve like pattern. That is another very important thing to note. Now if we see this real picture in the histology, here I'm sure you can appreciate this checkerboard pattern or this sieve like pattern in the nucleus. So that is also an indicator of immaturity. So the nucleus is still immature because of this sieve-like pattern. Okay, although the cytoplasm has matured because it is no more bluish, it is becoming more reddish actually because of hemoglobinization comparative to the previous one. So cytoplasm has matured, but nucleus has not matured because it is showing sieve-like pattern, chromatin pattern. So it is showing nucleocytoplasmic asynchrony. So that means it is a megaloblast. So this is a megaloblast. This is a normal erythroblast, and the right side is showing a megaloblast. Okay, that's how it looked like under microscope. Now I'll show you another slide. Okay. Now this is the bone marrow smear, and here in the left side you can see all those normal erythroblasts. Okay, so normal erythroblast in normoblastic stage. Okay, so these are all normal erythroblast or normoblast. There are some are small, some are big. Now look at the right side. Can you see megaloblast here? Right, so like if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, actually there are a lot of megaloblasts. Most of them are megaloblast. There are few small megaloblasts, few big, and can we appreciate the asynchrony here? Here the cytoplasm, which is paler, and like for example, take this one. Cytoplasm is paler, but the nucleus is showing sieve-like pattern. Can we appreciate this megaloblast? So if you find this megaloblast in the bone marrow, so then you can confirm it as megaloblastic anemia due to B12 deficiency, right? So this is a very important finding to diagnose megaloblastic anemia.